Hey guys, been a long time. Say hi, Ray Ray. Okay. All right, here we go. Let's update everybody from the Snap-on Toyota team. We've been on a roll lately. Had a good couple races. We started off with Topeka. Topeka was one of those races every race we've entered this year, we think, okay, this is going to be our breakthrough race. And for whatever reason, things happen. But believe it or not, we had for those of you who didn't notice, we had a stellar Sunday. Qualified 14th. Just had, got some stupid stuff happening to drop cylinders. And we showed up with a really good race car on Sunday. We raced Robert Height, I believe. It's so long ago now, I had to remember. But raced Robert Height. First round, I think second round, we raced, was it Wilkerson? Yeah, I think Wilkerson, and then Beckman for a third round. And listen to this, 4:09 first round, 4:09 second round. This is in the heat of the day, 4:09 semifinals. And then in the final, going up against Courtney Forrest was kind of an interesting race, just because we were, you know, it was uneventful for us. We were just no parts damage. The car was absolutely flawless. And we go up there, and I know that the 100th win for female drivers is on the line and all that good stuff, but no fingers in mouth, please. We were just wanting to kind of just take care of business and do our thing and not be a part of the, not be on the receiving end of that history, historic event. But it wasn't meant to be. We dropped a cylinder, I think, about 2.2 seconds into that run, which opened the door for Courtney. She was right alongside of us and slowly pulled away. And the rest was history. I think we ran a 4:22. She ran a 4:14 or whatever. But hey, she won. It's a good race. And looking back on it, though, we were in the pit area, licking our wounds and thinking, okay, something happened that didn't. So we didn't change anything. The car should have run a 4:09. Four runs have been pretty cool for a funny car. But upon further review, we had a blower that just was. I put a new fresh supercharger. On for the final, which I shouldn't have, knowing what I know now. It was damaged. The thing had it was gallings. In other words, it was just damaged on the end plates where clearances were too tight, and we just didn't have the boost. And then, anyway, that was the end of that. But you know, it was not meant to be, but what was meant to be, the very next week we go back to, back to back, we go to Englishtown, New Jersey, and set the all-time quickest funny car run ever at 3:95. Here's a time slip for it right here. We were racing, who were we racing? 33, Tommy Johnson. And here's the 3:95 right here. I don't know if you can see it. Spectacular early numbers, all wrinkled up. This thing went through a few hands, a couple beers. And just a spectacular run. And as much as I want to just jump up for joy and all that stuff, it dropped a stinking cylinder at half track. It only ran 310 miles per hour. In fact, if you look at right here, 310. Now, there's nothing wrong with 310, but that's really not the speed you would expect for that great of a run. That speed should have been 318, 320. In fact, Dale Worsham, that same round right in front of us, ran a 399 at 321, I think. So that's more of the speed we should have run. But, you know, so my point is that would have been a run that would have probably put it on. I know a lot of racers are going to disagree with this. It would have probably put the ET time out of reach for a while, maybe for a few more months. Now, it would have been put it out of reach for a while. No fingers in mouth, please. That's how you get germs, right? So, anyway, it was a great run. We didn't back it up for the record. We had to back it up within 1% during the event, 3:99. We didn't do it. But what we did do is go on to win the race the next day. Wasn't pretty. The opposite of, the opposite of Topeka the week before, we had a bracket car. We had just a car that wouldn't get a hold of the racetrack, but the guys in the other lane had a harder time, so we limped our way to the final, and there we were against Dale Worsham, one of my friends on the circuit with the Coletta DHL Toyota, and it's a good race. They were running, unbeknownst to me, they were running probably the only cars not smoking the tires. It was a challenging racetrack. It was pretty warm. And we went on to run a 4:12, our first full run of the day, and kind of redeemed our crazy race day. So it was great to win a race. We not only won the race, which we all needed the money, number one. It was great for Snap-on, great for Sioux City, great for Toyota, all the people that support us, Lucas Oil. But it also qualified us for the Traxxas Showdown for our second year in a row, so that was pretty cool to get in. I think that was the fifth car, sixth now with Tommy, went in this last week in Bristol. So it's a pretty cool elite group of people. I want to thank Traxxas for having that race. 100,000 to win, great to be in it, the top cars, so you got to earn your way in it. It's pretty cool. So that was about it. I don't want to talk about Bristol. We just had one of those races where we got behind due to weather. We didn't get to make the fast run, the night run on Friday night. And so we found ourselves, I think, 12th going into Saturday. And we just trying too hard, trying to go fast. The car smoked the tires both runs on Saturday. And Sunday was on a good run against Tommy, the eventual winner. We were on a really good run, but again, it car got loose out in the middle of the track, spun the tires, and that was the end of our weekend. So kind of a crazy last three races, but the good news is, as a tuner, is the car is showing some great potential. The car is running easy. It's making a lot of power. The engine's looking nice. We had scuffing pistons all over the place. In fact, we have enough ashtrays and souvenirs to last us for the next 5 years, I think. But we did manage to fix that problem. So heading into Epping this weekend, we're excited. And then in Chicago, our home track for Snap-on, basically, they're up the street at Kenosha. We feel real good. You know, we're right there. We're eighth in points, only a few rounds out of fifth. So a lot of work ahead of us, but we're looking forward to we're looking forward to finishing off these back-to-back races, getting ready for the Western Swing. So that's about it. Oh, in case you didn't see there, thanks for Mellow Yellow for making the driver medallions happen again. I know there was a few events we didn't have them, a few years we didn't have them, so it's actually a pretty cool thing. Rye asked me what this was. She's used to looking at the trophies, but it's got, has scribed on the back, English Town Funny Car 2014. Ah, pretty cool. Want to kiss it, Ryra? No. All right, that's it, guys. Love you. Peace.